I don't know if you saw this white paper that came out from, who's this economic, Cardi B. She said, let me tell you something. When I be complaining about food prices and you all mother effers be like, ain't you rich? Why you complaining about lettuce? Why you complaining about this? That just goes to show me when you become successful, when you have money, you're going to be effing. You're going to go broke soon because you're not budgeting. She said, I get a summary of the money being spent at my home every week so that when I'm starting to see that groceries is like tripling up, it's like, hey, yo, what the F? Lettuce was like $2 a couple of months ago. It's now like effing $7. Of course I'm going to say something. The F.
All right. This is the second time I'm going to try recording this. Because the first time it didn't work right. So I've made videos talking about predestination. So I've covered religion. And then I've covered social issues such as low-quality women and assholes with really loud trucks. And the whole loud vehicle thing, it applies to every single type of personal vehicle, okay? Whether it's a Toyota Corolla or a Honda Civic, if it's a Prius, I don't care. If your car is excessively loud, whether it be a muffler, your engine, a subwoofer, whatever, you're an asshole, and you have a tiny dick. So, now, since I've covered religion and petty social issues, I decided now I'm going to tackle the economy. And for this, we're going to talk about inflation and how to deal with it. Because it is no secret that everything is retarded expensive right now. Gas is expensive. Eggs are expensive because of the bird flu and inflation. And the cost of everything has gone up. I live alone, okay? I only have to feed myself. I'm the only person in my life that I need to worry about right now. And I can't not spend $150, $200 at the grocery store now. I only go to the grocery store once in a blue moon because I buy enough food that'll last me like a long time, and then I don't eat a whole lot, so I can get away with not going to the grocery store constantly. But when I do go, it's not like I'm buying enough food to feed 5 people for a month, right? And I still spend $200 every time I go. Like lately, I can't avoid spending $100 on just a handful of items now. I wish I had a receipt on hand that I could show you. Oh shit. Here we go. So this is perfect. This is a perfect example. So this is a receipt to my local grocery store. I bought a box of Dr. Pepper, a box of Fanta, oh, another box of Dr. Pepper, store brand peanut butter, store brand vitamins, an air freshener, deodorant, Sour Patch Kids, a gas can, something like 10 boxes of mac and cheese, a pumpkin, and some eggs, okay? And I spent $166. And the date on here, when was this? October 13th of 2022. And that $166 is actually $30 off because I had coupons and my store like rewards card. So without the discount, it would be closer to $190, so about $200. I'll put a picture of the receipt somewhere so you can actually read it for yourself. So I didn't buy a whole lot of stuff. I did buy some stuff that I didn't need. Sour Patch Kids and soda. Like, you don't need those things. But still, $200. And I didn't even buy that much. So inflation is crazy. The most conservative numbers for inflation are like 8%. today, but if you use the models that they used back in the 70s to calculate inflation, it's closer to like 18 or 20%. So inflation is ridiculous right now. And those prices are never going to come down. They're just not. Because we have demonstrated, we have proven to all these companies that we are going to pay the ridiculous prices. Even if inflation does slow and go back to the normal 2% every year, the prices aren't coming down. Why would they? We're still willing, we've demonstrated we're willing to pay the ridiculous prices. So in order to combat inflation, I have, I guess you can call it a three-prong approach. And none of it's going to be easy. None of it is going to make everyone happy. But I think not only will this stop inflation, I think if we implement all of this, we can actually reverse inflation and force the price of everything back down. Because it is insane how much more expensive everything is compared to the 70s. It's insane. So the first thing we need to do is stop printing money. Period. Literally, not a single penny more can be minted. Not a single dollar more can be printed. Because the more money you print, the more you devalue the currency, and the worse inflation gets. The worst, here's a history lesson. The worst thing that any president, in my opinion, has ever done to this country is Richard Nixon taking us off the gold standard. For those of you that don't know, the gold standard was a time when every single dollar in circulation, every penny in circulation in the country, in the world, was backed by gold. That means that for every penny, for every dollar, there was gold in a vault somewhere that you could turn in your currency to receive. It was like an IOU. It was a ledger. The money was supposed to be a ledger that represented gold in a vault, physical gold in a vault. So at any moment, you could walk into a bank, say, I want to exchange this dollar for gold, and they would give you gold. That was the whole basis of our currency. Then Richard Nixon came along and took us off the gold standard, which gave America just free rein to print money as much as they wanted. And taking us off the gold standard put us into a recession that we still technically have not recovered from. 50 years later, we have not recovered from leaving the gold standard. And that is what started the 2% inflation year over year. Because 2% is not a lot, right? I mean, something that was originally $5 may creep up to $5.10, and then to $5.25, and then to $5.35. And, you know, it's little tiny increases in price year over year, not taking into account the shrinkflation, where manufacturers remove volume, they remove pieces of the product, so you get less of the product for the same price, which is just inflation but sneaky. And it's tiny price increases across everything, so it adds up really fucking quick. And that interest, essentially, that inflation compounds every year. So the little price increase keeps getting bigger. But wages don't grow with inflation. You're lucky if you have a job that keeps up with inflation. With annual raises. You're lucky if you have that kind of job. If you work in the food industry, you're not getting an annual raise just on merit. Okay? And it's not going to be anything close to inflation. Like, I worked in fast food. I used to work at Raising Cane's. And I literally got a raise one time that was a nickel. one nickel. I got a 5 cent raise one time. That's how bad the food industry is. So raises never keep up with inflation. Merit raises never keep up with inflation. And so everything just gets more expensive and you can't afford to live. In 15, 20 years, you can't afford to pay any bills. And the people just entering the job market, we're living in that right now. People my age have to have 3 roommates to pay rent in an apartment, let alone get a house. I was fortunate enough to get a house before all the shit hit the fan, so I'm treading water, but it's hard. And so in order to combat this inflation, we need to get back on the gold standard. But that's not enough. And that is not feasible with the amount of currency currently in circulation. So what we need to do, we tell the Fed, you're not allowed to print money. You're not allowed to print any more money until the amount of gold we have in a vault matches the amount of cash we have in circulation. Okay? The problem is, cash in circulation, way the fuck up here. Gold we have in a vault is way the fuck down here. We gotta bring them into equilibrium. So what we do, the Fed loans out money to all the banks in the country. That's what the Fed does. And the Fed, the Federal Reserve, charges those banks interest. So Chase, Wells Fargo, Bank of America, all the credit unions, they charge you interest because the Fed charges them interest. Which is why when the Fed changes interest rates, the interest rates on all your credit cards change. So, the Fed isn't allowed to print money. That means they're not allowed to loan money. But the banks still need to pay back the money that they borrowed. And so now, every month, when the Fed receives the money from the banks, they're going to literally burn it, or they should literally burn that money, as in take the physical cash and throw it in a fire. Reduce it to atoms so that it no longer exists. Don't put it in a vault somewhere where you can like get it in case of an emergency. No, literally destroy it. Remove it from the equation entirely. We need to take cash that is in circulation out of circulation and not replace it, because that is going to drive the value of the dollar back up. And eventually, the gold and the cash will equal out. And then we have to put a rule in place that says the Fed can only print more money if we are able to back it with gold, which means we have to acquire gold before we can print money. That right there, it can be debated whether or not that will stop inflation or just slow it down. At the very least, it's going to slow it down to less than 2%. At the very least, minimum, that's the effect it'll have. 100%. So in order to reverse inflation, because it's not enough if the cost of goods is no longer rising, right? It's not enough if the cost of doing business is no longer increasing. We need to bring the cost of manufacturing down. And the only way to do that is with competition. So the next thing we need to do, okay, stop printing money, get back on the gold standard. The next thing we need to do is deregulate heavily in all these critical industries, especially in the food industry. A lot of people are like, well, just raise wages. Raising wages does not fix the problem. It has never fixed the problem. It has only made prices go up, and you're right back where you started. Because every single business, every single industry relies on human people that need to be paid hourly or salary. You have to pay a wage to human people. That is an operating expense. That is categorized as an operating expense. It's an expense to pay people. It's called the payroll expense. And when you force companies to pay their employees more, all that's doing is increasing expenses. So the companies, they're either going to replace people with robots, like we're seeing in the food industry, or they're going to raise their prices, which is what we're seeing everyone do all the time. So raising wages is not the solution. What we need to do is incentivize competition. And the only way to do that is to deregulate and make it easier and cheaper for new people to start new businesses to compete with the established big guys. So milk, eggs, sugar, flour, you know, all these industries are basically dominated by a handful of companies, and they set the prices. And some of them are actual competitors. I'll just put the chart right here to show you how little choice you actually have in the world. But if you want to bring prices down, you need more competition, because competition is the only thing keeping inflation in check right now. Everybody has to raise their prices because of the increased supply of cash and the increased operating expenses, but nobody wants to raise their prices too much too fast, because then they'll price themselves out of the market and no one will buy their product, and instead they'll buy the cheaper product. That's the only thing keeping inflation in check right now. So if you allow for new guys to come in by deregulating things so that it's cheaper and easier to get started, they can come in with some brand new technology and undercut all the big guys and take a huge market share. And it'll force the big guys to bring their prices down, because again, you've already demonstrated that you're willing to pay $10 for a dozen eggs, $15 for a dozen eggs, $8 for a gallon of milk. Why the hell would they ever bring their prices down? You're willing to pay it, so why would they ever bring their prices down? Even if the cost of manufacturing comes down, they're not going to bring their prices down. Or they're going to heavily reduce the amount that you get for the price if they bring their prices down. So if they bring their price down by 10%, they're going to reduce the amount of what you get by 15% or 20%. Because they want to keep their profit margin. And with that shrinkflation, they can trick you into thinking that you're getting a better deal. There were other points that I made in the first recording that I can't remember now. Yeah, that I think all of that together, all three of those things need to happen simultaneously. Stop printing money, get back on the gold standard, deregulate heavily. Because if we were on the gold standard, we wouldn't have been able to print trillions of dollars to send people free checks during COVID and to send over to Ukraine in support. We wouldn't have been able to do that. But those two things have fucked this country so hard. We printed more money in 2020 and 2021 than every other year put together. I think it's more than 50% of all the cash that America has ever printed was printed in those 2 years. It's something like that. There's a statistics. It's something like that. That is insane. And you think that doesn't devalue the dollar and cause inflation to fly through the fucking roof? Like, seriously? Richard Nixon was hands down one of the worst presidents we ever had, just for taking us off the gold standard. Like, fuck Watergate. Taking us off the gold standard was his biggest fuck up. Because we still have not recovered from that mistake. And nobody has the balls to put us back on it. No president. I've never heard a presidential candidate talk about putting us back on the gold standard. I've never heard anyone in Congress talk about putting us back on the gold standard. I know that Mitt Romney wants to abolish the IRS, which is, I'm fine with that. Fuck the IRS. And I know that Republicans now in Congress are trying to defund the IRS. They're trying to remove all the extra IRS funding from Biden's Build Back Better plan, which is cool. I'm totally down with that. Fuck the IRS. They can fucking burn in hell, the thieving bastards. But nobody's talking about putting us back on the gold standard. And that is the first step to ensuring America's prosperity. Because BRICS, B-R-I-C-C-S, it's a coalition of countries, Brazil, Russia, China, and a few others, India. They're coming together trying to replace the American dollar as the world reserve currency, because that is the only thing giving the dollar value. The American dollar is as much of a cryptocurrency right now as Bitcoin, because we can, it's actually worse because we can just print more. You can't just make more Bitcoin. There are actual rules for that. The American dollar, we can just print more, and it's insane. It's crazy. And BRICS is trying to replace the dollar as the world reserve currency, and as such, they're trying to replace the dollar as the currency that is used to buy and sell oil. The entire world uses the dollar, the American dollar, to buy and sell oil. The whole world. That is the only thing backing the US dollar right now. If the majority of the world decide to adopt this new BRICS currency, whatever it ends up being called, America's fucked. We're fucked. Because the BRICS currency will not only be backed by each individual country, it will also be backed by gold. There will be gold in vaults to back every single unit, I guess you could call it, of this BRICS currency. So it'll be backed by each individual country's economy. So if one country's economy fails, the whole currency doesn't fall apart, unlike the euro. It'll be backed by gold in a vault, and it'll be the world reserve currency. It's going to overthrow the dollar. It's going to replace the dollar. This is worse than the euro. It's going to be more catastrophic than the euro. It's going to be bad. And in order to combat that currency, we need to get back on the gold standard. That is the most important thing that America needs to do right now, is get our currency back on the gold standard. There's nothing that trumps it if we want to keep a strong economy. Now, China has their shit going on. India is not very strong. Russia's, like, all these countries individually are not very strong. China is the biggest, but they're not the strongest. So, you know, it's a very complicated issue, but it's scary. Sorry, this went off on a weird tangent. I was trying to talk about reversing inflation, and yeah. It's a whole thing. And I'm sure that there are smarter people than me working on it, but there are so many powerful people with so much money making sure that meaningful action is not taken, that, if I'm being honest, I don't think America's going to last very much longer. There are a lot of people with a lot of money to lose if America does fail, but America's not going to last much longer, guys. I'm pretty well convinced of that. But anyway, that's the topic that's been on my mind recently. Other than predestination, which I always am thinking about and seething in rage over. So, yeah, still suck at outros.